I love podcasts. I love listening to podcasts when I'm walking or when I'm doing housework. I think podcasts are an awesome democratic media type that have completely changed my life, and they might have changed yours as well. Now, I don't do a podcast anymore, but I do know how to create a podcast, and I'm going to show you that today on DOTTO Tech. Steve Dotto here. How the heck are you doing this fine day? At Dotto Tech, we make technology easy so you can do more. Now, today on the show, I want to take you through the process of creating a podcast. I'm going to talk about the hardware, the software, the editing, and the publishing process. We'll talk about all four of those. We won't spend too much time on the content of podcasts. We'll leave that for somebody that is wiser than me to coach you on. Instead, I'll talk about the technical production side of podcasts. But before we get into the creation of a podcast, I want to make sure that you know about Thinkific. Now, Thinkific is the tool that we use here at Dotto Tech to deliver all of our online courses and to create all of our online courses. And when I started to use Thinkific, it completely revolutionized my business. If you want to know how we use Thinkific to deliver both paid and free online courses and support our business here at Dotto Tech, well, I've got a link to a video below where I walk through the simple part of the process. Have a look. Now, let's get into the whole world of podcasting. And I don't know why it is that I like podcasting so much. I think it has to do with the fact that, first of all, I appreciate all of the podcasts that I get an opportunity to listen to, and there are a huge variety of terrific podcasts out there. In fact, I'd love to take advantage of this opportunity and have you tell me who your favorite podcasts are. But I think a big part of why I like podcasts so much is my history doing radio. I did a radio program for years and years here in Canada, and I was really steeped in the tradition of radio from the people who taught me how to produce radio programming. And I loved the process. I loved the history of radio. I loved the feel and the entire process of creating radio is so different than television and video. I just liked it. It always made me happy to be a part of it. So when I moved into the digital sphere and podcasting became a tool that I could use myself, well, I fell for it immediately. And I think it's just a terrific way to grow your brand, build your business. And it's far easier than you probably realize. Okay, I'm just going to jump in. I've started to edit this video and I recognize that there's this occasional audio hiss that's happening in the video. Now, I had two choices when I heard that. I could re-record the entire video, but I am having trouble tracking down where this audio interference is coming from. I think it might actually be in the power in this unit. It tends to happen on weekends when I'm recording on weekends when there's more people in the townhouse development. And so I think it might be a power issue. I'm not sure. I'm probably going to have to get some sort of a power cleaning unit put in, but I haven't done that yet. So rather than put this whole thing on hold while I figure out this issue, we're just going to have to suck it up, buttercup. I recognize that there's a little bit of irritating hiss. I apologize for it, and I am working on trying to fix it. Now, back to our regularly scheduled programming. We will begin with everybody's favorite topic, which is microphones, your audio recording setup. Now, I get asked probably more often what microphone I use than any other question as far as hardware is concerned. Now, I do have a hardware guide of all of the tools that I use for both producing my YouTube channel videos and all of my production work. It's called Steve's Toolkit, and there'll be a link below so you can see all of the tools that I use as well as a synopsis of the tools that we're going to be talking about right now. But essentially, when it comes down to microphones and audio recording, you've got two options. You've got the easy and less expensive option of going with a USB microphone. They start at about $60 or $70 through to about $300. And at the top end of that market, you get some really good quality USB mics that will do a very, very good job for you. They're easy to use because they just plug into the USB port on your computer and you're off to the races. Or you can get an analog mic. Now, mine is an analog mic. I use a Electric Voice RE20. Actually, this microphone is a legacy from my radio days. This was a microphone that I used in the radio studios when I was doing my radio show. When you use an analog mic, you have to convert the analog signal into digital. So mine goes through an audio interface, which converts the signal. And there's a variety of different audio interfaces you can purchase from around $100 to a couple of $1,000s, actually. Mine is actually the mixer that I use, converts the audio, the analog signal into digital, and then it plugs in by USB to my computer, and that's how I get the signal into my computer. And it's a little more advanced process. It takes a little bit more patience to set up, but the quality is pretty much as good as you're going to get in a radio studio or in a recording studio. But regardless of which direction you go, analog or digital for your microphone, the most important thing as far as getting good quality audio is setting up your system correctly, the environment that you set it up in, having it in a relatively quiet room that has relatively good acoustics. You don't always have control over that, I will admit, but what you do have control over and makes the biggest difference is making sure that your microphone's orientation is set up correctly for its recording capabilities. Each microphone has a kind of a cone that it will record most effectively in. This RE20 is a very close proximity mic, and the manufacturers tell you to be just to marry yourself right up tight to the microphone. This is so we snuggle right up to this mic. If I even move this far back from the microphone, you'll notice a significant drop in the quality. Knowing how your microphone works, where it wants your voice, and what orientation the microphone should be in to capture your voice is the most important thing in creating good audio. And it's so simple. They tell you right in the directions. So make sure you read the directions and pay attention to how your manufacturer wants your microphone positioned and follow that, and you will have good audio. Now you have good audio happening. What do we do with that good audio? We're going to record it. And there's lots of options for recording software. There are free options. If you're on a Mac, you can use their GarageBand tool. There are paid tools such as Adobe's Audition. And there's a variety of different audio editors, and most of them are going to do a really good job. Now, the one that I recommend all the time is Audacity. And the reason is, it's free and it's very full featured. You can find it here. We'll put a link in to Audacity, and it's a great starting point. And it's a starting point that you can use for free that you may never ever want to upgrade from and start paying for a service, because it's that good an audio editor. I've always been really, really happy with it. So let me open it up and show you how Audacity works. And it works in all environments, Windows and Mac. When you open a new session in Audacity, you're brought into the audio editing interface, which is basically just a multi-track audio recorder. And you can see along the top all of your different controls for choosing your audio input and setting all of your recording options. You've got kind of playback controls like you'd find in a VCR for recording or playing back if you want to use manual controls. But I use keyboard controls when I use Audacity because it's a tool that I use all of the time. So let's record a mini little podcast right now and show you the process of actually recording and then editing that before we output it. So let's do that in Audacity. So in order to start recording, I'm just going to hit the R button. And when I do that, you'll see that the waveform starts to get laid down. You'll actually see a visual representation of the spoken word. And I'll make a couple of purposeful little mistakes that I want to clean up in editing, and then we'll package it together. Ready for that? So I'm going to hit the R key to start recording, and then I'm going to hit the space bar to stop, just so you know what's happening kind of behind the scenes. Are you ready? 3, 2, focus, Steve. Hello and welcome to DOTTO Tech. I'm Steve Dotto. I'm glad you're joining us today. Our show's dedicated to helping you get the most out of your technology wherever you use it. There. Now, I purposely had a little cough in there so that I want to edit it, but look at what we have right in front of us here. We have an audio form, the waveform of the spoken word. I love editing audio because it's such an immersive experience. Let's have a listen. Let's just have a listen. So I'm going to hit the space bar.
Hello and welcome to DOTTO Tech. I'm Steve Dotto. I'm glad you're joining us today. Our show's dedicated to helping you get the most out of your technology wherever you use it.
That was kind of the opening that I used to use on my radio show. So now what I'm going to do is I am going to clean it up. So I've got here a series of different editing tools right here that will allow me to choose this iBeam, which is basically a selection tool. I'm going to highlight the waveform where I had that cough, and you saw where it was as well as I did. I'm going to highlight that. I'm just going to hit delete, and just like that, I've cleaned it up and tightened it up. So let's have a listen to that part.
Welcome to dottotech. I'm Steve Dotto. I'm glad you're joining us today. Our show's dedicated to help.
It was like I never coughed. So if you want to, you can go through your entire podcast and you can take out every stumble, every little mistake that you made if you want to. But really, for most of us, it's designed to take out bobbles or coughs or some the doorbell ringing and editing and tightening it up and adding other interviews and adding music. That's the way that we use the editor a little bit more than just cleaning up every little stumble that we made, but you've got the option. So now if I was going to create this as a podcast, I would have, of course, much more recorded. But the next thing I want to do is I want to bring in my audio bed, my audio soundtrack. And so I'm going to import into this some audio, and I've got my audio file saved right here. And this is the theme music that I use. Now, I've used it for ages. Now, we see it happening here, and we can see the audio, we can see the music, and we can see my voiceover. And now we can position my voiceover appropriately to the theme music. So if we have a quick listen to from the top, it'll all be kind of jumbled together.
Welcome to dottotech. I'm Steve Dotto. I'm glad you're joining us today.
Okay, so obviously I don't want that to happen. I want the music to start, and then I want the music to fade a bit, and then I want my voiceover to start. That's typically the way you're going to do things. So I'm going to choose my move tool here, and I'm going to slide my voice down. And then I'm going to have a quick listen to the audio track, and I'm going to find that first kind of lick. At that point there, when it's just through that first lick, that's typically where I'd like to bring the audio volume down and bring my voice in. So now how do I control the audio volume in this waveform? I love doing this part. I'm going to put the insertion point in right about here because that's about where I'm going to want it to start. And I'm going to go to my tools here. I'm going to choose the envelope tool. And the envelope tool, if I do a click right where my cursor is, it's going to set an insertion point. And then I'm going to put a second set in right here, just in a, you know, just a few seconds in. And watch what happens as I pull it down. And that actually changes the audio level for that, for everything that happens. We can actually visually envision the fade of the audio by using the envelope tool. Isn't that cool? I just love this. So let's go back and let's have a listen to that. And it fades down. And that's where I want my voiceover to start. So let's bring my voiceover and let's tuck it in so that it starts just as that video, just as that audio drops. All right, let's have a listen again.
Welcome to dottotech. I'm Steve Dotto. I'm glad you're joining us today. Our show is dedicated to helping you get the most out of your technology wherever you use it.
Okay, at that point there, I want the audio to come back up, right? I'm done with the introduction. I'm ready for it to come back up. So I'm going to add another envelope insertion point right here where the audio ends, where, and then I'm going to go just a few seconds beyond, and I'm going to swell it back up. And actually, I can, if I want to, I can just pull that in a bit more. And I can pull this over a bit more because I realize I started a bit late there. Here we go.
Hello and welcome to dottotech. I'm Steve Dotto. I'm glad you're joining us today. Our show is dedicated to helping you get the most out of your technology wherever you use it.
And that makes me happy. It makes me happy editing audio. I don't know why, but this is one of the most fulfilling things you can do. All right. I've finished now editing together a nice half-hour podcast or a one-hour podcast interview. I've dropped in all of the different elements that I want. Now I want to export this, so I choose export, and I take the entire file, and I'm going to export it as an MP3 file, and I'm going to call it My Podcast, and there it is. So it's being exported as an MP3 file, and you can go through and you can set the bitrate, and you can kind of get into all of those sorts of things, but this is the basic process. It'll export it now, and now we've got an audio file that we're ready to publish, which is what I'm going to show you next. We've now recorded, edited, and output our podcast. It's time for us to publish it. Now, for the publishing of a podcast, you have to have a service that is a podcast host. So what a podcast host is it's a service where you upload your podcast, they host the podcast, and they distribute it to the different podcast services that are available online, such as iTunes or Stitcher Radio. Any place that you go to subscribe to a podcast, They act as a middleman, taking the content from the content creator and then publishing it to that service. Now, technically speaking, what they're doing is they're creating something called an RSS feed. I know it's going to get a little bit geeky here for a moment, but that's a real-time subscription service. You set it up so that with each one of those services and your host account, you set it up so that every time you publish a new podcast, a notification goes out to iTunes or to Stitcher Radio that Steve has uploaded a new podcast, and then it notifies all the people on that service that are subscribed, and they can then download or listen to the podcast. It's how we broadcast and distribute the product. So it's a very important part of the equation, and it's probably the most complex part of setting up your podcast. Fortunately, it's something you only have to do once. I'm not going to walk you through that process right now, so don't worry, it's not going to get too technical now, because each of the podcast hosts has a slightly different way of walking you through the process. But it's something that you will do once. Once it's done, you're ready to go. Now, the podcast host that I use and I've used for many years is one called Podbean. They're based in Canada. Quite like them. They're a good quality service. Would I recommend them over any other? Not really, because I haven't used any of the other services, but it works just fine for me. When you log in to your podcast host, you're usually going to be brought into some sort of a dashboard that gives you analytics. And since I'm not currently publishing podcasts, my analytics look pretty sad. But this is the tool that you're going to be wanting to look for. This one right here, which is the publish tool. This is where you take the recording that we just created and you create a podcast out of that recording. So we're going to sit here and we're going to go publish new episode. When we do that, we're going to upload the podcast file that we have, which there is just called My Podcast. Of course, this isn't going to be a real example because it's just a short little demo that I created. But then it uploads that file, and then just as if you're creating a blog post or any other post on your website, you're going to add a title, you're going to add a description, and you're going to publish your podcast. Now, you can take the feed from this published post and you can embed it in your own website and you can share it in a variety of different ways. But this process here right now of publishing is pretty much identical to the experience that you have publishing a post on, almost even publishing a post on Facebook, but certainly it's very similar to publishing a WordPress post if you were publishing something on your own website. So that's the process that gets your podcast out to your community. It's quite a bit of work to set up the first time, a little bit confusing, maybe a little bit of anxiety attached, but once it's been done and once you've set it up, it's just plug and play. Every time you upload a podcast, you're ready to go. This process becomes very second nature and very easy to do. And that's how you publish a podcast. How you grow the podcast, that's up to you. Now, I will put links in the description of the people who I turn to, who I think give great advice on the content and how you actually build your community using podcasting. I don't think I'm the expert on that. But now you understand the physical process of creating a podcast. And I'm wondering if it might be something that you're going to dive in and do. I would love to hear from you if this is a process that you feel compelled to do yourself. I hope you found today's video to be useful, entertaining, or enlightening. And if you have found it to be any of those things, a couple of favors. First, please share this video with others and let them know about what we're doing here in dottotech. If they're interested in podcasting, you might just put them on the right path. Secondly, if you've not yet subscribed to our channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button and ring the notification bell so you hear when we upload any new episodes here at dottotech. Till next time, I'm Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.